Morning student, welcome to computer online class. This is Guna from Good Samaritan School. Today we are going to start chapter 4, chart in MS Excel 2010. In this chapter we are going to learn about meaning of chart and its types, different ways to create a chart, changing chart type and chart style, change or delete text and data in a chart. What is mean by chart? A pictorial representation of numeric data is called chart or group. It is a visual representation of data. A picture is worth a thousand words. Is one of the famous common proverb. What is the meaning of this one? It means a picture may convey idea more quickly and effectively than the written word. So it is a visual representation of data. Let us see what are the advantages of chart. First one is attractive manner. It allows us to present statistical data in an attractive manner as compared to tables. And next one is compact manner. We can easily specify the more than one number in a single chart. So charts present data and information in a compact manner. Understand and compare. We can easily compare one value with another. Long-lasting effect on mind. Chart have a long-lasting effect on the mind than a simple data statement. Let us see what are the components of chart. First one is plot area. It's an area where the data in your chart is plotted. It is bounded by two axes. First one is value axis or y-axis or vertical axis. And the next one is x-axis, category axis or horizontal axis. If you want to draw the graph, you already know two values are needed. One is x-axis value and another one is y-axis value. And the next one is data points. A data point is at any single or unique piece of information. It represents the data value. Next one is legend. The legend is often located on the right-hand side of the chart. It identifies each data series in a unique colors or pattern. We can easily understand in chart which color represents which value. And the next one is chart area, which encloses all the elements of a chart. Yes, now let us see what are the different types of charts available in the MS Excel. First one is column chart. The column chart are used vertical column to show numerical comparisons between data. Next one is line chart. Is used to show the change of data over a continuous time interval or time span. Each line display in different color. Next one is pie chart are widely used in various fields to represent the proportion of different classification and compare various classification by the R. Students, this pie chart is not suitable for more data because the data increase, each slice becomes smaller. So a pie chart display one series of data. A data series is a row or column of number used for charting. And the next one is bar chart. It's like a column chart lying on its side. And the next one is area chart. Area chart are like line chart, except that the area below the plot line is solid. And the last one is scatter chart. We can plot the different points with value. Let us learn how to create a chart in MS Excel 2010. Students, let us learn how to chart in MS Excel. There are two ways to create a chart. First method using F11 function key and second method using insert tab. So first I explain how to create the chart using F11 function key. Student, this is a student table. It contains four fields. So I'm selecting all the fields now. First you got to select all the fields and then you got to press the F11 function key in your keyboard. So let us see, Excel automatically create the chart for us. This chart will be displayed in separate worksheet in the workbook. This is the shortest and easiest way of creating the chart.
Students, in this method, only column chart will be displayed. If you want to change the chart type, you can change it. Chart style also you can change. I will explain later how can you change the chart type and style. And the second method is using the insert tab. So let us see how to create a chart for our choice. In this method, you can create any type of chart. Let us see how to create a chart using insert tab. First, you have to select the cell and then click the insert tab. And this next, you got to select the type of chart you want from the chart group. These are the different type of chart. See here, this is the column chart. It contains different type of column chart. And then this is the line chart. This contains different types of line chart. And the next is the pie chart. See here, different type of pie chart. This is the scatter chart. This is a different type of chart display in the chart group. You have to select the type of chart you want from this chart group. Now I am choosing here column chart. Here, which type of column chart you want? Type 2D column or 3D column or bar or 3D bar, which one you want? You can. So here I am selecting column chart. See here, the chart will be displayed on your screen. See this in the corner. This is the corner handle. Using this one, you can resize your chart possible. You can minimize also possible. You can maximize also possible. See, this is the chart title. If you want to give forward title, you can give. Just double click it and then delete it. And then you have to type any title for our table. Just to specify student table. See here, this is the first student roll number is 1 and the name is Abhi, and then see the mark. First one is the max mark, value is 75, and then second is the science mark, value is 78. And this is the second student roll number and the name is the Marshall, and then see the max mark is Hunter and the science mark is 98. This is the third student, this is the fourth and then fifth student. If you want to change this colors of the data series, that also you can possible. Just to double click this one. After that, see this in the right side. See here. See here, this option will be displayed. Now, see here, this is the bucket option you got to choose. Choose the fill option. After that, you have to choose the color, which type of color you want. Here, direct color also you can choose. Other more color, that is a combination of color you want to choose. You can go there, standard and then customer. Here display in the more colors. See here, suppose I want this color I want, pink, and then click OK option. See here, now color change. So using this way, you can change the color. Understand? Like this, you can change all the color also possible. Select it and change the color. See here. So now see, max mark is pink color and the science mark is this color. So this is the way you can change. Next topic, I am going to explain how can you changing the chart type and style. Student, see in this window, as the chart gets created, two new tabs appear on the ribbon. That is the design tab. Another one is the format tab. So with the help of this command in this tab, you can do various changes in the chart. First, I may explain how can you changing the chart type. So first, this is the column chart. You already know this one. I want to change the chart type. How can you do this one? See here, go to the design tab and click the change chart type option. See here, this is the change chart type option. You got to click it this one. And then choose the which type of chart you want. Suppose I want the line chart. You can choose it. Or pie chart. Which chart you want? Select that. And click OK option. This is the line chart. See here. Again I explain. First you got to select the chart. And go to the design tab. And choose the change chart type option. So in this window, you got to choose which type. Suppose I want the bar chart now. So click bar chart option and then click the A. So this is the way you can change the type of the chart. Suppose you want to change the style of the chart. This is the bar chart, but I want to change the different style of the bar chart. So click it that one and then go to the design tab. See, then the chart style option is displayed, different style of bar chart. See here, select any of the chart style. See here, let us see, your chart style will be changed. So this way you can change the chart type also possible, chart style also possible. Next, I want to change the value of this chart. Suppose I want to change the name or roll number or marks. How can you change it in the chart? So Excel chart and data and text are linked together. So any changes in the worksheet is automatically updated in the chart. Suppose I am going to change this student's name. Here I am changing the name. See here, I am going to change the name. See here, I am going to change the name. So automatically the changes reflected in the chart also. This way you can change the data. Suppose I want to change the marks of this student. See here, it's 100. First student max mark is 100. So now see here, also, so now change, this is the max mark, first student max mark is 100. This is the way you can change the data in the chart. And the next, how can you delete the data under text in a chart? Suppose I want to delete the this last student detail. How can you delete this one? So you can delete the data in the table automatically, is reflected in the chart also. Click the delete option. So now see, this data will be deleted in the chart also. This way you can delete with data from the Excel chart. And the next, how can you move the chart? Resize, I already explained. Using the corner handle, you can move the you can resize your chart. Minimize also possible and the maximize also possible. And then how can you move the chart? So you can point anywhere in your chart. See here, the four handle arrow will be displayed. Using this arrow, you can drag it to a desired location. See, using this handle, four header and handle, you can move it to a desired location. So this is the way you can resize and move also possible. And the next, another one type, different type of chart also is there. That is the sparkline chart. Next one is the sparkline chart. Sparkline chart is a tiny chart that gets embedded into a single cell in the worksheet. It provides the visual representation of a cell data. See here, sparkline chart is displayed within the single cell. For example, I want to compare the mark 178. So this two values ka mark will display in the single cell. Same like second row and then third row and then fourth row. How can you create this sparkline chart? First, you got to select the rows. Which value you got to going to select? First, I want all this cell I want. And the next, you go to the insert tab and select the sparkline chart. So this is three type of chart will be displayed. This is the line chart, this is the column chart, this is the bin and loss. Bin and loss means suppose the cell value contain the, suppose we can specify the positive value also possible, negative value also possible, and then now zero value also is possible. According to the value, the chart will be displayed. So first choose this value and then choose which type of chart you want. Suppose I want the line chart, you got to choose the line chart. Here two options, data range, which data range you want the chart. And the next one is where you want to display the data. See here, CG already data is there. I want to display the chart in the E4 to E7 because the value in only in the C4 to D7. So I want to display the value in this cell range E4 to E7. So here you got to specify E4 : E7. Press OK option. So now see that this is the column chart. If you want to change the line, sorry, this is the line chart. If you want to column chart, see that this is the column chart. And the next to see the win and loss. See the win and loss, these are the positive value. That's why the chart will be displayed like this. Suppose if I'm specify any negative value here, see here. See the second value where it is displayed. See the position change now. Suppose I specify the zero value. So the second part is not displayed. So this is the sparkline chart. This way you can create the sparkline chart within the single cell. You can change the type also possible. We can change the style also possible. And this is the way you can create the chart. You can create the chart in two ways. One is the using F11 key. Another one is the using insert tab. This is the pie chart. So I'm going to print the chart. How can you do that one? First select the chart and go to the file tab. And click the print option. Here you have to select the which type of printer you are using, that you have to select, and then copies you have to run, which type of orientation you want, landscape you want or portrait you want, how many pages that you are. Here I am created only one pages only. Suppose you are in Excel, you are created the 10 pages, me you have to specify here 1 to 10. After that click the print option. This way you can print the chart. These are the way you can create a chart and change the chart type and style, everything. You have to practice all these options. Chapter 4 has been completed. Thank you.